line should be discouraged, the green line should be encouraged, but only these 16 are experienced by human body. This 5 plus 4, these 9 states are experienced only by an enlightened body. That's what I call God consciousness. If you just have an understanding, insight about these 9 states, 2 things can be done. 1, you will be able to identify right master. This is the, if you understand these states, this is the scale, this can't be fake. Unfakeable states, anything can be fake. Except these states, 9 states. All these 9 are unfakeable states. Understanding about these states will give you a very clear understanding about finding a right master. Second thing, falling in tune with him. Third thing, you will be able to measure the experiences happens in your space if you are understanding about these 9 states. Because all the experiences happening in your space should be helping you to experience these 9 states. Unless these 9 states are exactly felt, the experiences you are having may be psychic or psychological. It is not spiritual. To scale and measure, master, to scale and measure your own spiritual growth, this 9 states, understanding about these 9 states is important. Conscious waking. No thought. This is the exact state people experience when they sit as a divyasari medium around me during the session. They are conscious, but whatever is seen in the waking state is seen by them. Even though they are in the legal path, but whatever is seen by the world, by you all, is also seen by them. They are not lost control. That is why, whenever their body rolls on the ground and they appear, people who see, for them it feels like they lost control on themselves. I tell the divisaries, the mediums, to put thread in the grid. You will see without threading, just like that they will put it. It means they are not lost control. Completely, things are under their control. This is conscious waking state. Conscious dreaming, in that same state, any idea passes by in their inner space, conscious dreaming. Conscious sleeping. When an enlightened being rests his body, it is called conscious sleeping. When an enlightened being is putting his attention on something, conscious awareness. When an enlightened being is in samadhi with himself, it is called conscious consciousness. Understand? These 9 states here, waking consciousness, again, when you are completely established in enlightenment, when your body gets completely right, that's what I call an incarnation body, where all 12 strands of DNA is awakened, then whether you are waking, dreaming, sleeping, or awareness, or consciousness, whatever you will be doing, you will be radiating God. I can say, this is all the things happening during the Nirvikalpa Samadhi. This whole thing happening during Sahaja Samadhi. This is Sahaja Samadhi, this is Nirvikalpa Samadhi. I am just giving you the basic technical understanding. It is going above your head, don't worry. Especially Srinarayani participants. This is just 9 o'clock. You are going to eat. So, you don't need to bother too much about 9 o'clock. Actually, when you go to a new country and see 9 o'clock, you don't pick up based on the taste. Because you haven't tasted any food. You just pick up based on the name. Or some way of understanding, idea, or how visually it is presented. That is the way you pick up. That is why, you see, now again you have the same problem. You know all these dates. But now it's just a menu card. How will you pick up? You have some vague idea. That's actually a little technical idea. How it will feel like. And visually it will be presented. That is why it is presented visually. So that you can pick up the state. Understand? It's a menu card. Just in the enlightened state, a different state phases you go through. Now, all you need to know is simple technical understanding. Maybe in the sessions, I'll give you more deeper understanding, techniques, and method to experience. Of course, experience itself. So here, I'm introducing. Please understand. This four level, the 16 state is experienced by human beings. In that 16, this 6 should be avoided, this 9 should be encouraged, and the other 9 is never experienced by human beings. It is just to give you an understanding. It's like this 9 states understanding will clear a lot of your doubts. When you have a spiritual experience, how to find out whether it is spiritual or just psychological? When you are with a master, how to find out he is a completely enlightened being or he has only one or two powers? These major doubts can be clarified when you understand these states of consciousness, because it's a very important thing when you choose your master. Once you choose, no question of looking back. But for choosing, this will really help you. When you have any energy experience, that night, if you are complete consciously means, next day morning, you will not feel tired. You wouldn't have dreamed. You wouldn't have slept. You will remember only you have been completely aware. You are completely aware, but there was no thoughts, no dreams, and morning, no tiredness. You are fresh and alive. This is what I call sleeping consciousness. If you experience this state, then you can be sure you have had energy darshan from a person who is consciously sleeping. Understand? If you had experience of conscious sleeping, you can be sure you had darshan, energy from person who is sleeping consciously. If you had experience of sleeping consciousness, be sure you had the darshan energy from person who is consciously sleeping. Means you are master is the right person and you are having the right experience. And same way, if it's just from some psychic person or black magic person that kind of people, your night sleep will be very intense, tense, loaded, heavy. Morning you will feel as if your whole body is beaten. Your whole body is beaten. Please understand. I am not saying a normal body pain. If you work out too much, you will have body pain. If you do too much yoga, you will have body pain. That is different. This pain will be completely different. As if you never slept, you will feel a deep dissatisfaction that you never slept. Something is going on. You are uncomfortable, settled. It means your master is neither spiritual nor you are having spiritual experience. These are some of the clear scales. Not only that, when you have energy dashan, energy transmission, diksha. You are waking consciousness with your back. That means when you morning wake up and see, whole thing should look more deeper. Green should look more greener. Rose should look more rosy. And color should look very deep. Things should appear very pure, as if completely washed, fresh. If you are experiencing the conscious waking, you have received darshan from person who is waking consciousness. If you are experiencing waking consciousness, you receive darshan from person who is in conscious waking state. This understanding about each state will give you the clarity about the master and the path you are traveling. Are you growing? Are you progressing? You will understand that. The next is the conscious dreaming and dreaming consciousness. If you had a nice darshan in the night, even if you had one or two dreams, you will be just aware that dreams are moving better. Clean conscious light, the dreams are moving like a line, like a picture. How in the screen, the projector, scenes are moving. Like that in the screen of your consciousness, this will be moving. If you are clear how that moves in your inner space, you are conscious, you are dreaming. That state, if you go through, be very clear. If you are consciously dreaming, you can be sure you receive darshan from a person who is dreaming consciously. If you are consciously dreaming, you receive darshan from a person who is consciously dreaming. Sleeping consciousness, I'll explain. Early morning, you will not have tiredness, alive, fresh. And this awareness consciousness, just for no reason, you will be sitting in his presence. You will have pure awareness consciously. You know you are in pure awareness. You are in pure awareness. So if you are having the awareness conscious experience, you are in conscious awareness. So this is what I call Upanishad. The experience of Upanishad. Of course, finally the conscious consciousness merging with him, becoming him, becoming one. That state has neither definition nor scale or anything. That state of conscious consciousness can never be explained. It is just the stuff. Now, understanding about the states will give you the scale to work with yourself and work with the master. With this scale, measure every day what is happening in you. Then you will be able to very clearly feel which direction you are going. Are you in the right direction? Are you in the right person? Because before starting your work, you need to know, are you in the right direction? Are you in the right person? After that, forget about everything. Just flow with it. Flow with energy. Now, you have a scale. Maybe in the continuing, tomorrow and day after tomorrow sessions, I'll give you more techniques on about each state and methods to encourage the states to be encouraged, discourage the states to be discouraged, experience the stages to be experienced. I bless you all, let you all achieve experience.